Right, so I have picked out two questions for you guys from CSIR net June 2016 paper. Okay, both are 4 markers from inorganic chemistry, and it's very simple. So whenever you are not able to do some questions or a moral is down, just attempt questions from topics you already know, just to boost up your morale, okay? Because your morale should not be down when you are preparing for the exam. So just to boost up your morale, you do pick out certain questions from topics you know well and solve them, just to get a boost. Okay. So now this question, the number of skeletal electrons. It is given the number of skeletal electrons you have to find, and we are given three compounds: C2B3H5, C2B4H6, and B5H9. Now there's obviously you know how to solve, and if you haven't seen my video on skeletal electron pairs, I'll attach a link over here or at the end of the video, okay? So you can watch that video and then come back and solve this question. Now, like I had told in my previous video, how to calculate the skeletal electron pairs, it's very simple. But if you see the options, now if you see, there is 12 in one option. Let's see the different options and see which one should we pick first. So you see there is 12, the third one will be the most easiest to calculate, and you have 12, 14, 14, 12, okay? So this is the easiest to calculate, and if you calculate this, your two of your options will be eliminated. So when you know a question, okay, it's very important now to do the question in a very short span of time, okay? So don't get overexcited. Sometimes I've seen students getting overexcited and they start solving the question and they waste a lot of time. So you have to be smart as well. You know the question, that's really good, but now you have to be smart. So you see that if you solve this third one, right, you'll be eliminating two options, okay? So this is known as the method of elimination. So let's solve. So B5H9. So total number of valence electrons for 5 boron, so 15. Plus 9 hydrogens, so 24 valence electrons. Right, 24 valence electrons are there. Now what you do? Now we calculate for boron, like I told you, it's a non-transition element. So you take 5 into 2. Right, so this is 10. So 24 minus 10 will give you 14. So there are 14 skeletal electrons. They have asked skeletal electrons, they are not asked skeletal electron pairs. Remember that. If they are asking pairs, then you have to divide this by 2. So now you can eliminate option number A and you can eliminate option number D. Okay, now you are left with only B and C. So again, if you see in B and C, both, this is 12, 14 and this is 10, 12. So you have to solve either one of them and you will know the answer. So let's try with this one, C2B3H5. Okay, so carbon, you can write it as BH, right? Because carbon contributes 4 electrons. Okay, so you can write it as BH. Okay, that is one way you can do it. Or if you don't want to do that, you can just generally calculate the carbon. So there are two ways. Either you write it in the form of BH, because BH also is an equivalent to carbon and it also contributes 4 electrons. Or you can actually do it otherwise also. There is no problem. You can just take carbon also as a central atom. That is the atom participating in the cluster formation, and take 4 valence electrons for carbon. So you can do any which way, it won't matter. So now let's do it the normal way, so that will save time, okay? So 4, so 2 carbons, so 4 electrons from each carbon, so 8, right? Then borons are 3, so 3 into 3, 9, 17, plus 5 hydrogens, so 8 plus 9 plus 5, 14, plus 8, 22, right? Minus how many? Minus there are five atoms participating in the cluster and all are non-transition. So 5 into 2, 10. So that means 12 minus 10, that is 12. So our option is option number B. So you see, you have no need to solve all the three clusters. You can just solve 2 clusters and get to the answer. And that's why I am telling you, identify the options. Now if for example there was an option where if you see that there was 14 in only one option, right? Or if there was, see, for any one of them, there was only one option present. For example, if there was only one 14 present, over here there are two 14s, right? For example, there was only one 14 and here it was written, say, 16, if it was given 16. So that's why it's very important to identify the options. Now, if you identify the options and you see, okay, if you solve this, the third one, you might as well get the answer. So just try and solve the third one, because if you solve the third one and if it comes either 16 or 14, you directly get your answer. Okay. Now let's look at the next one. The next one is that it was given on heating this compound eta5C5H5 molybdenum CO thrice and whole twice. That is, it is a it is a dimer basically, right? And if on heating it was heated and we got it's the question said that two CO groups were removed. So if two CO groups are removed, you obtain eta5C5H5MOCO whole twice, right? Two CO from the whole compound, whole cluster, you can say, was removed. Two CO were removed. So we had CO3 whole twice. Now we have CO2 whole twice, right? And it says, what is the change in the bond order? So you see there are two molybdenums. There are two metals basically, and both are molybdenum, right? So you just have to calculate the number of metal-metal bonds in this case. Now again, I have done a video on this, you will see the link here. There is one way is, like for example, if you are given more than two metals, right, three metals you are given, then how will you calculate the bond order? Then you have to calculate bond order per metal, for which I have given the formula in the video, okay. But if only two metals are present, only two metal atoms are present, then what happens is, then you can just calculate the number of metal-metal bonds and that will also be equal to the bond order. You getting it? Like for example, if there are four metals, right, and total number of bonds, total number of metal-metal bonds comes out to be four, okay. Or say let's say the total number of metal-metal bonds comes out to be eight, okay, and there are four metal atoms. So you cannot say, you cannot predict the number of, you cannot say that it is the bond order. For bond order, you'll have to calculate further to calculate the bond order, because there are four metals. But if there are only two metals and two metals are forming, say we get there are five metal-metal bonds in the coordination compound and there are only two metals, so only those two metals will be forming the five metal-metal bonds. So you can say the bond order is five, right? So just remember this case. In this particular case, where there are two metal atoms, where we can calculate the number of metal-metal bonds and that will be equal to the bond order. But when you are calculating for more than two metals, then you have to separately calculate the number of metal-metal bonds and separately calculate the number of the bond order. Okay. So we have change in bond order it's asking. So like I have stated in my video, 5 electrons from this molybdenum contributes 6 electrons. 5 plus 6, 11. Plus 6 3 CO contributes 2 electrons and there are 3 CO. So 6 electrons. 2 into 3, right? So 5 plus 6 plus 6, 6 plus 6, 12 plus 5, 17. And it's whole twice. So because I told you it's a dimer. So 5 plus 6, 11 plus 6, 17 into 2. So this it comes out to be 34, right? And formula was 18 into N. So 18 into N, where N is the number of metal atoms. So there are two metal atoms in this case. So this comes out to be 36. And so calculating the number of metal-metal bonds, 36 minus 34 upon 2. This is the formula that I have given. Okay, you can check out my video. I'm attaching a link. Okay, so we get equal to 1. So now we have got equal to 1, right? So again, eliminate two options. We eliminate this one and we eliminate this one. Okay, now we are left with 1 to 2 or 1 to 3. Now see, again I'll tell you, in this case we had 2 to 3, 1 to 2, 1 to 3 and 2 to 4, right? So they were, in the second case, they were 3, the bond order was given to be 3 and it could be either 3, 2 or 4, okay? But for example, in some other compound it was given 5, for example over here, instead of 3, it was given 5. Now you know there are four different options, 5, 2, 3 and 4. Now you know that if you calculate the bond order for this particular compound, you can directly come on to the answer. So then there is no need to calculate the bond order for this particular compound. That's why it's very important to look at the question and not get excited if you know the answer. Quickly look at the options and try and find out whether by solving only one of them can you get the answer or not. If it's possible, then go for that particular solution. Okay. So you got bond order 1. So for this it was 1. Now let's calculate for this. Same procedure. eta5C5H5 5, it contributes 5 electrons, plus molybdenum 6 electrons, and there are 2 COs. So 2 COs will contribute, each CO 2 electrons, so 2 COs 4 electrons. So 5 plus 6, 11 plus 4, 15, right? And it's a dimer, so 15 into 2 gives us 30. Again, 30, yeah. And again, 18 into n, 18 into n will remain same because there are two metal atoms. So 36 minus 30 upon 2. This gives us 3. So the correct option is the bond order changes from 1 to 3. So option number 3. 4 markers they were, and you can see how easy they were. Okay.